I just wanted to start my video off on a different note of something that I was actually having a discussion with my sister with. I just want you to listen to it quickly and you...
And then, do I need to look extra in my videos, or it's just really more about content?
So... I was speaking to my sister, like I said, and she wants to open a YouTube channel. And I've also been consulting with people that want to open YouTube channels. And this is a very common question I get asked. Is it more about the look or it's more about the content? And it's a very good question that I've also, had to ask myself as I've been making content for YouTube. And if this is something that interests you, you know, stay tuned and really listen to my thought process here. And also let me know in the comments below what you think about this. I'll actually share something that's personal to my journey starting off on YouTube. So with the people I was watching on YouTube, like makeup gurus and everyone else, everybody always came out looking glammed up. So I always thought this was something I needed to do. Like every time I have to do a video, I am putting up an act, I have to spend like an hour or so putting on makeup before I even come and talk about the content I'm actually doing. And not to get it wrong, I actually enjoy doing makeup because I actually do it for other people, for clients, and it makes me happy, you know, to make someone look good, to feel fabulous and really feel so confident in themselves. But then I was just like, do I really need to do this? And I found that every time I kept on doing this for my own videos, it was actually draining. By the point I had to come and actually do the video and deliver the content that is what is actually the most important part of the video, I was just kind of discouraged. And some videos I would actually shoot and finish and not actually post because I am so tired, or I do a makeup look and then I have to force myself to shoot a makeup video and then come and do a content creation video because I felt the pressure of always having to look good for the camera all the time. Up until I think I did a video recently where I was making maguinya. So I really was like, I just had my hair tied up and I came up about and I was like to my fiance, I want to make this video. I've been making maguinya and, you know, I really want to share this video and it's actually doing all right, you know, on the channel. And I got a comment from one of the most supportive YouTubers out there named Simply G. Go and subscribe to her channel. She's really awesome. She was like to me, why do you wear makeup? You look so beautiful without it. And it's something I never really thought about because I was like, it's kind of like something that you don't even actually internalize, that you always have to look perfect all the time before you go on camera. You always have to have makeup done. You always have to, you think about your outfit, you think about how you're looking. I'm not saying don't make an effort, because in the preparation of you starting to do a video, that's when you're actually starting to go through your thought process. But I just feel like being you, being yourself is the best way to actually come out there and talk to people, because people can relate. Because some of the looks and some of the videos I'm actually thinking about, I was sharing really good information, but I'm like, girl, but did you really need to have that orange and blue makeup? Did you really have to be that extra for delivering a video about, you know, cameras, about TikTok, about phones, about editing? You know, it wasn't really a video about looking good, but it was about me delivering content that was quality. Granted, the content was good, but then it was like, if a person has to start watching the video, am I distracting them with how I'm looking? And are they really gonna get the gist of my message? And, you know, I would say for someone that's starting out to do YouTube out there, do what makes you feel comfortable. If you're a person that already wears makeup every single day of your life, you wake up, you are done up head to toe, nails looking nice, everything looking good all the time, then that is you. But if you're a person that stays most of the time looking natural, that's me. I'm a makeup artist. I do makeup. I enjoy playing around with makeup, but I promise you, you will not bump into me at the mall or in the shopping center glammed up to the gods, you know, with the face beat of the gods. You will find me looking like this, like God's truth. So I would say, be you, be comfortable being in your own skin and really showing off the personality that is you. Because at first I feel like we have the pressure of being the people that we watch. At the end of the day, you are what you feed, you are what you consume all the time, and you end up wanting to be that person, but not understanding that what makes Patricia Bright different? What makes Nima Tang different? What makes so many other YouTubers out there so different? What makes Peter McKinnon different is the fact that he's himself, is the fact that she is herself, and the content that she's trying to deliver makes her or him deliver it the way they do. You know, you have to also think about the content that you are doing. What is more important, the substance that you are talking about or the look? So if it's both, then do both, but do something that you know can be sustainable for the longest time. The whole thing of consistency is not you posting videos all the time. It's you having the same energy for what you're doing all the time. If you meet me out there, this is how I'm speaking. This is how I'm going to be chilling. This is the t-shirt I'm going to be wearing. And you know, sometimes I will do things that will make me feel good, because at that time, that's how I want to feel. But I want you to get used to seeing me in the different forms that I am, seeing me for me and not for the facade that I'm trying to put out there to the world for the camera to see and all that other stuff. I don't know if that makes sense, and I hope it makes sense. And if you're someone that's already a YouTuber, let me know how this has been for you. Like, just trying to be yourself and trying to, you know, share good content at the same time. How has that process been for you? And if you're someone that is wanting to start a YouTube channel, this is something to really think about. What can you sustain in the long run? Because at the end of the day, YouTube is a long-term game. Whether you're taking it for business, as a hobby, or whatever it is, at some point, if you're pretending, the jig is gonna be up at some time. I'm telling you that you are gonna face burnout if you're pretending to be someone that you are not. And at some point, the things that you do are going to show off and are gonna come out at some point. So I say, be you, be comfortable. If you feel like having makeup, having the face beat of the gods, do that. If you feel like coming out and being natural and being authentic and being you, you are definitely going to attract people that resonate with that, that like what you're doing. And most of all, it's about your personality. You're a brand. Everybody's a brand. You are like that bar of soap in Clicks. And there's a reason why someone uses Dove over Protex, over Lifebuoy, over so many other brands. It's because of the way it makes them feel, what it represents to that person. And you as a person represents something to someone that someone admires, that every time you post a video, someone wants to listen to what you're saying, someone wants to see you, someone wants to get in the comments and talk to you, someone will go out of their way and look for you on your social media and be like, hey girl, I really like you, I really like what you all about. And I think that's what's really important. But you know, let me know in the comments what you think of this. It's something that really just, it's a video I didn't plan on, it's a video I didn't script, it's something that just came about and I just thought I'd speak on it. But anyways, as I started the video, I didn't introduce myself. I'm Tatenda Henani. If you're new to this channel, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments what you think. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. If you're already part of the family, thank you so much for the support. I really appreciate it. And I will be seeing you in my next video. Me and my undone nails are going to be seeing you in my next video. Bye for now.